Blake, a taser was not successful. According to the family's attorney, Blake was breaking up a fight when police arrived. This morning, he remains hospitalized. His family says it will be a miracle if he ever walks again.
The first thing he did when he looked at me was cry and then begin to say, I'm sorry about all of this. He says, because I don't want a burden on anybody and I don't think I'm going to walk again, Mom.
Unity becomes one of the main aspects of what has to happen in this community. And that unity is only going to happen if all of us work together. So the city has been working along with other entities of putting together a number of committees that are going to be working on systemic racism and dealing with how we're going to improve our community and give everyone a voice.
The shooting is now threatening the NBA season. The league postponed all playoff games last night after the Milwaukee Bucks refused to play, protesting against Blake's shooting in Kenosha.
We're calling for justice for Jacob Blake and demand the officers be held accountable. For this to occur, it is imperative for the Wisconsin State Legislature to reconvene after months of inaction and take up meaningful measures to address issues of police accountability, brutality, and criminal justice reform.
17-year-old Kyle Rittenhouse is under arrest in connection with the deadly shooting of two people following a night of unrest in Kenosha Tuesday. ABC News confirming that Rittenhouse is the person seen in this graphic video where he's running from a crowd. Rittenhouse falls and then appears to begin shooting. Law enforcement officials tell ABC News that social media accounts associated with the name Kyle Rittenhouse are part of the investigation and that the accounts have now been deactivated.
Chief Meteorologist Ginger Z here in Port Arthur, Texas, and I wanted to bring you through this hurricane. Yes, there's still a hurricane in Louisiana moving north. So it made landfall as a Category 4 hurricane. You can see Houston's lights on the left there. It made landfall overnight. The bulk of the storm impacted southwestern Louisiana. So Houston and Galveston were spared. We even did not have anything more than power outages here. But boy, much more can be said from Cameron to Lake Charles. Now Alexandria to Shreveport dealing with some of those hurricanes. Hurricane-force gusts and those outer bands and even that feeder band that stretches back to Baton Rouge could have tornadoes with them and flash flooding. Lake Charles, Louisiana, 137-mile-per-hour gust was recorded. These are just preliminary numbers. We'll see some of these potentially go up because it was making landfall as a Cat 4. But remember that this storm not only carries with it 5 to 7 inches easily of rain, you could see up to a foot, but as it moves northward, it's still going to cook fast, right? So you're going to have wind problems, you're going to have power outages all the way through Arkansas as it remains a tropical storm, and tornadoes into even Mississippi with that feeder band. So watch for that because all the region shaded in yellow there will be impacted. Finally, this thing moves out and toward Kentucky and eventually the mid-Atlantic late week into early weekend.
Pour jouer au hockey, il faut savoir patiner. Dîner.
Back with one and only Bob.
Gill's partner up called Johnson's.
What's the mission this morning?
Okay, we're going to fly up towards Division Delta, the coordinates up the knot there. We did some protection in there last night. We fired the ridge up and kind of secured that. There, we got a little bit of heat up in a few pockets up here on top, but one of the advantages of this fire is when it passes through, there's very little residual heat and mop-up concerns. So things are looking good here at Delta. Once again, coming up to 139, head north. So far, nothing has spotted over the top of our containment lines into the Rome Creek drainage, but we do have an alternate line started in there in case it does. This thing's been kind of unpredictable. We got good coal black up here on top, secured up in here. Yeah, once this drops over the top, that'll be Division Kilo, which comes up to 204, heading west up the Rome Creek drainage. Just a little rumor control. We heard that folks were thinking that it crossed the Rome Creek, but it did not. And that's the Rome Creek drainage off the nose. See crews working down in there, securing that edge, improving that line.
Good afternoon. On the eve of the 57th March on Washington, I will speak about the recent events in Kenosha, Wisconsin, the wildfires raging across the California coast to the Rocky Mountains, the storm, which is working its way through Texas, Louisiana, and the Gulf Coast, and most of all, about who we are as a country. We are a nation that at its best loves, protects, and